Postgres can do some really cool things like vector searches, full text searches on unstructured data, and it can run some complex JSON queries. But for years, you've only been able to use it on the server, not anymore, because PGLite gives you the full power of Postgres right inside your browser. PGLite is a WebAssembly build of Postgres that's 3 megabytes when gzipped and was created by IndexedDB in collaboration with Neon and Superbase. Okay, 3 megabytes isn't as small as the WASM build of SQLite, which is about 0.5 megabyte. But PGLite has way more features and has support for a bunch of extensions, and also have reactive queries that update when data changes without having to refresh manually. In fact, let's go through a React and PGLite project. But before we do that, don't forget to hit subscribe to get more of this kind of content. Here is a basic to-do list that's been created with Vite and React and stores data with PGLite. It does this by creating a table called to-dos table using the exec method, but there's also the query method if you want to pass parameters into the query. Then this instance is passed down into the app component using the PGLite provider. And inside the app component, we're using the use PGLite hook to insert data into the table whenever we submit the form. And we're also using the use live query hook to automatically show updates whenever there's a change to data in this query. Without using the live query hook, we'd have to use an effect to show updates to the data whenever it changes. Currently, PGLite is storing data in memory, which is great for ephemeral apps. So if I refresh the page, we lose everything. But if you want to persist the data, you can use IndexedDB or OPFS, which isn't supported in all browsers. So we can update our project to use IndexedDB like this, which means now if we add data and refresh the page, we can see it doesn't go away. There's also support for a multi-tab worker, which allows multiple tabs to share the same database, support for Postgres full text search, and a bunch of other features, as well as support for ORMs like Drizzle, libraries like Vue, and frameworks like Next.js. But as cool as PGLite is, it's still very early days, and it has a few shortcomings, like a single connection limit, limited protocol support, and in some cases, it's still slower than WASM SQLite. But that hasn't stopped Superbase from using it for database build and Electric from using it to sync browser data to server data. So while PGLite doesn't have the speed and memory efficiency of SQLite, it does have a promising future for things like running AI agents locally or doing real-time vector searches in the browser, which are both things I'm really looking forward to.